Dr. Kalani Brady from the John Aber School of Medicine comes every Thursday, and he's here with us now. Morning, Doc.
Good morning.
You know, he's so cute. He tries to match with me every morning. So you turn on the TV, and then you're like, what's Diane wearing? Green.
Exactly.
Oh, we're olive.
Yes.
Handsome as always.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, so we've got some viewer questions. A woman says she's been hearing a lot about women developing cancer from talc. She's wondering if putting it in her underarms is also at risk for cancer.
Probably not. It's where you use it in the genital area, and then it goes up the vagina and affects the ovaries, and it leads to a risk of an increased risk of ovarian cancer. So under the arms, probably not a problem.
People used to use it on babies too.
Yes.
For the same thing, and it's the same issue going.
Right, but there's cornstarch powder, which is safe. So I'd recommend switching from talc powder to cornstarch powder.
Okay. Is having no platelets hereditary, and what could have been done?
It can be hereditary. It is basically where the body fights itself, and the battleground is the platelets. So the body actually destroys what platelets are normally produced. And the treatment for this is really to get a hold on the antibodies, sometimes using anti-inflammatory drugs like steroids can help. Acutely, when there are no platelets or very few platelets, we give a platelet transfusion. But of course, the body will fight those platelets just like the ones that we have naturally.
Okay, and then a woman asks, how dangerous is an irregular heartbeat? What can be done to control arrhythmia, right?
Right. There are many different kinds of irregular heartbeats, Diane, some of which are totally benign, totally without any clinical significance. Other heartbeats that are irregular can be controlled with beta blockers. Some require a pacemaker. Some actually require a defibrillator. So it really depends on what kind has been diagnosed as to what the treatment is.
Yeah, I'm aware of that because my mom has it, and she doesn't need
anything
defibrillator or anything.
So
yeah.
She has one of those benign, mm-hmm. irregular heartbeats.
A woman asks, I suffer from severe chronic neuropathy. Will there ever be a cure for diabetic neuropathy?
Unfortunately, we have treatments for diabetic neuropathy, and they're sort of okay. Drugs like Neurontin, which is gabapentin, and Lyrica, which is pregabalin. But the real treatment for diabetic neuropathy is prevention of diabetes in the first place. And you can do a lot to prevent diabetes, including activity, diet restrictions, weight loss if you're overweight, so that you don't end up with diabetes and then the diabetic neuropathy.
Okay, more questions to come. Doc's back at 7:20.